you will note whether ignorant, whether people know it, but yet such mass gathering is being gathered there during Hajj. You will find this kind of behavior, most of the people will be following this without understanding, still also. They will be emotionally involved, they cry such tremendously, and they avoid fight, they do not argue and debate. You cannot move a mass gathering in such an accurate manner if you go there. Anybody gather anywhere, the amount of people that are gathered here, and they move from Mecca to Mina, then Mina from Mina to Arafat, and Arafat to Muzdalfa, and then they come back to Mina, and then they go, this is Mecca. This mass million people are doing, and there are no fight and debate or fighting. In normal, if you see in a gathering, a huge mass gathering, people start fighting. So badly, there might, some people can be there, you know, but if you see in the mass, so they are lean, they are leaning, meaning they are with emotions are there, and they are inclined with emotions and feeling and intellect. So on these things, they will not fight, they will not have obscene talk, and they will not take the liberties. They will not argue. Otherwise, they are taking the liberties here, and they are fighting also. But there you will find people are very sober not to do this all. So this was the order given to Ibrahim as salam. In Surah Al-Baqarah 2, Ayah 131 and 124, إِذْ قَالَهُ رَبُّ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When his Lord said for him, submit, he said, I submit for the Lord of the worlds. Allah says to Ibrahim Islam, do you submit the orders that I have given to you for the Hajj and other things? Here he says, إِذْ قَالَهُ رَبُّ أَسْلِمْ, do you submit? And Ibrahim Islam said, I submit to the Lord of the worlds. Whatever you tell me, I will submit. So now further, in Ayah Baqarah 2, 124, Allah gives a trial on him. وَإِذِ تَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّ بِكَلِمَاتِ فَتَمَّهُنَّ قَالَ إِنِّي جَعَلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا قَالَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِي الظَّالِمِينَ. And when his Lord put Ibrahim to trial, with words, then he completed them. He says, surely I have made you the Imam, the leader for mankind. He said, and from my offsprings, he said, my covenant shall not reach the oppressors. After Ibrahim al-Salam submitted, Allah ordered him, or Allah put Ibrahim al-Salam to trial with words. Words means whatever if I'm reading these words, these are words of Allah. So through those words you receive, you are in trial. You have to complete whatever you've been hearing. Similarly, Ibrahim al-Islam, what Allah said to Ibrahim, so he pointed out the house, you have to purify for those people. These are the words. If you follow and obey, then you complete. Similarly, he put him with his words, whatever the words were given to him, meaning whatever the message was given to him, he was tried by the words, and he completed them. And once he completed, Allah made him the Imam, the leader for all mankind. This is how Ibrahim al-Islam became the Imam, the leader for all mankind of all times. Then he asked Ibrahim al-Islam, وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي, meaning he pledged that from my offsprings, give me Imams, leaders, like you have given me the honor. So Allah says, قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ, for the oppressors, my covenant shall not reach the oppressors. Whoever soever will be an oppressor in the world, Allah will not make him the Imam, the leader. So this is the condition laid down. Now, what is the Imam position or the leader position? What is the leader for what? In all aspects. So I'll give you a little short aspect where he is referred as the Imam. Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 125, وَإِذِ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَثَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنًا وَاتَّخِذُوا مِنْ مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلًّى وَعَهِدْنَا إِلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ أَنْ طَهِرَا بَيْتَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْعَاكِفِينَ وَالرُّكَعِ السُّجُودِ. And when we made the house a place of reward and safety for people, and you take the place of Salah prayer from the standing position of Ibrahim, and we covenanted with Ibrahim and Ismail that they should purify my house for those who go around and use as itikaf, dedicated or devout or retreat, and who bow and prostrate. Now he, first of all, he was made the Imam, the leader for all mankind. He asked from his offsprings. So in this ayah you will note that the what is the status of Ibrahim in the house of Allah is mentioned this ayah, that his status is that Ibrahim, maqam-e-ibrahim in the house is that he is the standing position of Ibrahim in the house. وَاتَّقِدُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ صَلَّىٰ. What is Maqam Ibrahim? He's the Imam, where Imam stands in front of all of us, where he recites the Salah. That is the Maqam or the standing position of Ibrahim. Where the Imam leads, he's the Imam, Ibrahim is the Imam in the house of Allah. So you will note that if you go to Mecca, where Imam stands to lead the prayer is Maqam Ibrahim. That is the status or the standing position of Ibrahim Aslam, where he stands. Where the Imam stands. So he is representing the Imam of Ibrahim al-Islam. So Allah is asking for us to, you also, all mankind of all times, you, وَاتَّقِدُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ صَلَّىٰ, that you take from the standing position of Ibrahim your Salah. So we got the Salah, the prayer is from Ibrahim al-Islam. And further he says, because he was asking from his offsprings, so his offspring is mentioned here is Ismail, there are other as well. But at the moment he says, وَعَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ أَنْ طَهِرَا بَيْتَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْعَاكِفِينَ وَرُكَّ السُّجُودِ. And Ibrahim, and we covenant with Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam, both of them, that they should purify my house for those who are going around and using as an itikaf or devout, who are dedicated there, sitting there looking at the Kaaba, they can stay there, and who bow and prostrate. Here the further Ismail al-Islam is included, and with the, that is this portion of Anaya, I've already delivered a lecture, what was the vision of Ibrahim, because he asked an Imam from his offsprings. So in the Quran, the dream is mentioned, the whole process is mentioned, and he got the Imam. So he become in front of us, Ismail al-Islam. That is why his name is mentioned, that the now the covenant is between both Ibrahim al-Islam, Ismail al-Islam. First it was only for Ibrahim al-Islam, now Ismail al-Islam also is doing the same thing. وَعَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ أَنْ طَهِرَا بَيْتِيَا. That Allah made a covenant with Ibrahim and Ismail, that you purify my house, again for those who? For those who are going round and making a retreat or itikaf, who are sitting there dedicated, devout, who are rukwa sujood. Same thing, almost same thing. So now Ismail al-Salam and Ibrahim al-Salam, both of them did this. So his zuriyat offspring is also included here. First Ibrahim al-Salam Imam, and then Ismail al-Salam is an Imam mentioned in the Quran, because he purified the house. So by reading this, we are coming to know that you are listening to the millat of religion, system or the millah of religion of Ibrahim al-Islam you are hearing. Surah Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 127. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And when Ibrahim and Ismail raise the foundations or the principles from the house, O our Lord, accept from us, surely you are hearing and knowing. Now, what was the principles or the foundation of the house was that do not associate anyone with Allah. And Allah made a covenant with Ibrahim and Ismail Islam that they will purify my house for those who are going around, who are standing, bowing and prostrating. That was the covenant. So now here says, Allah says, that وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ. When Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam raised the foundation of the principle of the house, meaning they made sure that they purify the house for those who are going around, who are standing and bowing and prostrating. For them, they did it. And they raised this foundation. How they raised it? By purifying the people's minds. That is how Allah's house was raised. If you are clarified that no, there were no idols in the house of God, there were, if you know that, you have to understand the ayahs and understanding of the ayahs, because Allah says the clear ayahs are the standing position of Ibrahim. You believe in the imam, that's the prayer that established the prayer there. So he has to purify the house for them, they both of them. So when they did it, so Allah said they raised the foundation, the principles. And then they said, O our Lord, accept from us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيرُ عَلِيمُ. Surely you are the listener and the hearer, you are hearing and listening. So this is how Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam raised the foundation of the house, by purifying the people's minds. This is how the house is purified. Surah Ibrahim 14 and 14 Surah 39 ayat. Alhamdulillah alladhi wahabali al-kibari Ismaila wa Ishaq inna rabbi la sami'u ad-du'a. The praise is for Allah who has bestowed upon me in old age Ismail and Ishaq. Surely my Lord is hearer of calls. Now Ibrahim al-Islam in the Quran, another place, he was asking Zuriyat, offsprings, that they should become imam. You know, just now we have read before that when he got the imam, he was made leader, he asked for his offsprings. So here Allah says that he says, Ibrahim al-Islam, Alhamdulillah alladhi, the praise is for Allah who has bestowed upon me in old age Ismail and Ishaq, and both of them were prophets, because both of them did the same what Ibrahim al-Islam was ordered to do. So Allah accepted the dua or the call of Ibrahim al-Islam in relation to imamat or the leadership. So Ibrahim al-Islam got the leadership, then further is his son Ismail al-Islam got the leadership, and then thirdly Ismail and Ishaq, and then Yaqub also, and then Yusuf. There are many, his full nation is mentioned in the Quran as prophets. So this is how. Further in Surah Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 132, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And with this Ibrahim and Yaqub left the testament for his sons. O my son, surely Allah has chosen for you ad-deen, the judgment. Then do not die except Muslims. Now, previous ayah is speaking about Ibrahim al-Islam, Ismail Ishaq, and the son, Ishaq's son is Yaqub. Okay? So in this ayah, he says Allah, because now you see the third personality is also introduced. With this Ibrahim, with what? The testament is the further written in below. With this Ibrahim and Yaqub, not Ismail, Ishaq is already there. They got the imamah. Now Yaqub is saying, with this Ibrahim and Yaqub has left the testament for his sons, for the sons, Yaqub's sons. Yaqub was the father of Yusuf, his sons. O my sons, surely Allah has chosen you for you ad-deen, the judgment. Not religion, the judgment. Then do not die except you are Muslims. In Arabic here is again deen, ad-deen. That you have to take the judgment and you will be, because the judgment were later in the Quranic ayahs. So here they say, Ya banayya inna Allah, so Allah has chosen you for you and gave you the judgment. And do not die except you are Muslims, submitter for Allah, for Allah's ayat essence. So now Ibrahim al-Islam got the imamat, Ismail Ishaq, and now Yaqub is departing from this world, and including Ibrahim al-Islam said the very same thing, because Allah said that Ibrahim also and his Yaqub also left the testament. That means both of them, not the same time, but Allah is repeating in together. When Ibrahim al-Islam left the testament, maybe Ismail al-Islam went, left the testament, and now Yaqub al-Islam is the son of Ishaq al-Islam. فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And further says Al-Baqarah 2, Ayah 133, أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَىٰ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتِ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدًا وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And Allah is questioning the mankind, were you a witness when death came to Yaqub, when he said for his sons, what you will serve after me, who will you serve or what you will serve after me, they all said, we will serve your God and the God of your fathers, ancestors, Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, who is one God, and we are submitters for him. So Yaqub alayhi salam, when his death came, Allah said, were you a witness there? Were you a witness when what happened at that time? So his rhetoric question, and then the answer comes that he says, he asked his children, that is, Yusuf is mentioned already, Yaqub's son Yusuf by name is mentioned, but there were many other sons. So he asked him, who will you serve or what you will serve after me? What you will serve, who will you serve? They in return say, Kalu na'bud ilaha wa ilaha abaika Ibrahim, who's a messenger prophet, his God. Ibrahim alayhi salam is Allah. Then he says, Ismail is a prophet. Wa Ishaq is a prophet. And Yaqub himself is a prophet. Same to Yusuf and others. So Yusuf alayhi salam is a prophet. So they in return say, we will worship or we will serve the God of Ibrahim, Ismail and Ishaq. And Ibrahim is the grandfather and Ismail and Ishaq are the uncles of Yaqub alayhi salam. And that God is one God. And we are Muslims. So this is millat of Ibrahim, you are listening. Now, I will describe an event or a hadith of Ibrahim alayhi salam. In Surah Zariyat 51, page number 1011. Hal ataka hadithu dhaifi Ibrahim al-mukrameen. Has the hadith narration or event came to you of the honored guest of Ibrahim? And Surah Hud 11 and 69 ayat, وَلَقَدْ جَاءَتْ رُسُلُنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ بِالْبُشْرَى قَالُوا سَلَامًا قَالَ سَلَامٌ فَمَا لَبِثَ أَنْ جَاءَ بِعِجْلٍ حَنِيدٍ. Without doubt, our messengers came to Ibrahim with good news. They said, Salam, peace. He said, Salam, peace. So he did not stay or wait that he came with a roasted calf hurriedly. Now in this ayah, or the narration is that to Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah is asking, is telling us that he's narrating a narration or hadith of the Quran related to messengers came to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Messengers. And when the message came with good news, and they said salam, peace. So in return Ibrahim alayhi salam said peace, salam. So, you know, Ibrahim alayhi salam was very, very halim and forbearing. So he did not stay there, you know, that he went back, he hurriedly went and brought a roasted calf for them. He thought his guest, a human being guest. So he did not stay there and brought this hurriedly roasted calf for him to eat, for these guests. But they were messengers, you know, for in the Quran there are angels mentioned as messengers, Rul Amin is mentioned as messengers, and human being is also mentioned as messengers. So here we can safely say, because the angel is not mentioned in the Quran, that they eat. But the Quran doesn't say they were angels. The Quran only speaks they were messengers that came the good news to give to Ibrahim al-Islam. What the good news I will read further. But Ibrahim al-Islam thought they are human beings. They went hurriedly and brought some roasted calf. Did not wait there. Now what happened? Surah Hud 11, 71, 72 and 73. Verse 71. وَمْرَأَتُهُ قَائِمَةٌ فَضَحِكَتْ فَبَشَّنَّهَا بِإِسْحَاقٍ وَمِنْ وَرَائِ إِسْحَاقَ يَعْقُوبٍ. His wife was standing, so she laughed. Then we gave her the good news with Ishaq, and from the back of Ishaq, Yaqub. قَالَتْ يَا وَيْلَتَا أَلِدُ وَأَنَا عَجُوزٌ وَهَذَا بَعْلِ شَيْخَ إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ. She says, oh alas, shall I have a child? I am an old woman and my husband an old man. Surely this is an amazing thing. Now when the good news were given, what was the good news? when they came, she laughed. Who laughed? Ibrahim's wife was standing there, she laughed. When she laughed, the good news was given to her. And what was the good news? Was that the good news of Ishaq al-Islam, a righteous prophet. And after Ishaq al-Islam, Yaqub al-Islam, a righteous prophet. This is amazing thing. She says, this is amazing that I am old and my husband is old. How can we have a son, in other words? That's not possible. We are old. We have passed that age that we can have a son. So Allah says in the further ayah, the angel said, or the messenger says, قَالُوا أَتَعْجَبِينَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ عَلَيْكُمْ أَهْلُ الْبَيْتِ إِنَّهُ حَمِيدٌ مَجِيدٌ. They say, you are amazed from the order of Allah, the mercy of Allah, and His blessings over you, Ahlul Bayt, people of the house. Surely He is praiseworthy, glorious. Amazing thing is, and now, amazing now, deeply amazed, that Allah in the whole Quran says Ahlul Bayt, people of the house, to Ibrahim's family. Why? Ibrahim was a prophet, Ismail was a prophet, Ishaq al-Islam was a prophet. Ibrahim al-Islam was a prophet, Ismail al-Islam was a prophet, Ishaq al-Islam was a prophet, Yaqub al-Islam was a prophet, and Yusuf al-Islam was a prophet. Whole family, this is a nation. Ibrahim is a nation. And he says, the angels or the messenger says, are you amazed from the order of Allah, the mercy of Allah and His blessing upon you? Ahl al-Bayt. This Ahl al-Bayt, the people of the house, is mentioned in the Quran only by these people, to these people. The other Ahl al-Bayt that people have made is not mentioned in the Quran by name at all. Now you people are reading the ayahs, we people are reading the ayahs. Allah has given the highest status, and Ahl al-Bayt is mean people of the house of Allah's house. It is not referring his own personal house where he lives. People of the house, because they all raise the foundation of the house. Ismail salam, I read it before. They raise the foundation, they purify the house for people who are going round and bowing and prostrating. So they are all the people of the house. Who? Ibrahim al-Islam, Ismail al-Islam, Ishaq al-Islam, Yusuf al-Islam, they are all the prophets, and his wife also. So they are the people of the house in the Quran, Ahl al-Bayt. People of the house of Allah. And whoever. And because Ibrahim says, Ummat, a nation. So this nation, you are listing the whole nation. And if you become a part of it, you are that in that nation. How you become the Ahlul Bayt of people of the house? You yourself, we ourselves can become the people of the house. If you do the same work, you listen to the ayat further. But the question here, you must understand, the whole family, this in the Quran, Ibrahim al-Islam is his family, all wife and his sons and grandsons, they were all prophets. They are a nation and the people of the house. They have one concept all the time. They had that belief in the same God, same Allah, and they purify the house. Same. That is why Allah referred to them, you are the people of the house, Ahl al-Bayt. So you must know clearly who are mentioned in the Quran as Ahl al-Bayt, the people of the house, clearly. Now another hadith is mentioned. Why I'm reading this? Because once you get the message of Allah, he got his whole family, got the message, his family, his wife, his sons, every grandson, everyone. But how to talk to his father? Because in the Quran, his father was a mushrik. Again, there is a mention of the Quran, how to talk to your father if he's not with the Islam. How? So this is why I've mentioned this ayah, another hadith or narration about Ibrahim Islam, how he pleads or deliver the message to his father who was a mushrik or who associated with Allah. Maryam 19:42, 43 and 44. فاتبعني أهديك صراطا سبيا يا أبتي لا تعبد الشيطان إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لِلرَّحْمَنِ عَصِيًّا. When Ibrahim said to his father, "Oh my father, why do you serve those who do not listen and do not have the insight, and they cannot enrich you about anything? Surely, O my father, without doubt there has come to me from the knowledge what did not come to you. So follow me, I will guide you on an even way. O my father, do not serve Satan. So surely the Satan is disobedient for the most gracious." Now, we all must understand that there are situations, if you want to become a nation of Ibrahim al-Islam or to follow Ibrahim al-Islam, you must know how to speak to your father or parents. This is how Ibrahim al-Islam spoke. He is an example. This is how he is saying in very nice manner, "Oh my father, why do you serve those who do not listen and who do not have insight?" You are listening to those who do not have an insight. Basarat, they don't have basarat. They don't have insight. And they don't have insight, and they cannot enrich you of anything. So this is the ayah which all of us should know, that how to talk to your father. There is a lecture, coming lecture, I will be doing parent-children relationship. How to talk to your father. If you got the message of the essence, and if you are in the nation of nation with the Ibrahim al-Islam, then this is how a person should develop the way, because the knowledge has came to Ibrahim al-Islam, his sons and his whole family, but his father was not with him. So this is how he delivered the message. "Oh my father, without doubt there has come to me from the knowledge what did not come to you. So follow me, I will guide you." What the knowledge has come to, there are situations in life that the knowledge that has come to us, my father or ancestor may not have it. So if you are becoming, or if you are taking guidance, and if you take the guidance from Allah, and if the ayahs are understood by you, then how to deliver the message? So you have to, you don't have to say in the air. You open the Quranic ayah and read this narration to him. Because the ayat itself works. If you start talking in your own language, you'll create confusion. Because Ibrahim al-Islam is the messenger, the prophet, he narrated these ayahs to his father. And further his father says, to father, "Do not serve the Satan, so Satan is disobedient for the most gracious." These are simple understanding how to talk to your father if you have got the message. You know, message does not mean if I know something of the ayat is message. Until your qibla or the direction of belief is changed and you are convinced of it and you practice it, you don't lose the loose talks, and you are really confirm on it, then you deliver this message. Otherwise, you know, just coming, taking knowledge and talk to your father, you will get, that's not the procedure. That's a separate lecture. But anyway, further he says, "Ya Abati," in Surah Maryam 19:45, 46 and 47. "Ya Abati inni akhafu an yamassaka adabum min ar-Rahman fatakuna lishaytan waliya fatakuna lishaytani waliya. قال راغب أنت على آليتي يا إبراهيم لئن لم تنتهي لأرجمنك وهجني مليا قال سلام عليك سأستغفر لك ربي إنه كان بي حفيا." "Oh my father, surely I fear that the punishment touches you from the most gracious, so you will become the protector for Shaitan." Ibrahim said, "Do you dislike about my gods, O Ibrahim? If you do not stop, I will definitely stone you and leave me for a long time." Ibrahim said, "Peace be upon you. Soon I will seek forgiveness from my Lord. Surely he is affectionate with me." You see, the understanding, the feeling is that the father and son relationship is in such a bondage that he was afraid of his father being punished. fear the punishment touches you from the most gracious. So will become, if you become the protector of Satan. How a person, this guidance is not just words. If you have got the guidance, and if you fear that your father will be punished, that is what Ibrahim Hassan says, I fear that the punishment touches you from the most gracious, so you will become a protector of Satan. And that the situation is that the Ibrahim Hassan said, father said, because of his arrogance or because of his belief in the wrong concepts, he said, do you detest dislike about my gods, O Ibrahim? In his mind or in his concept, Ibrahim's father's concept was that Ibrahim al-Islam is detesting or disliking the gods of Ibrahim. But he did not. If you do not stop, Ibrahim's father said, if you do not stop, I will definitely stone you.